thanks so much for joining me here today as we get to talk about one of my favorite subjects, comic books. My name is Jose. I love comic books. I love talking about them. I love sharing them with you. Feel free to follow me on social media if you would like. Links are in the description below. I've also posted a link to the Marvel fan site that I have plot synopsis and character bios for this issue. Daredevil 172 from 1981. I do not have this issue in its original form. I do have it in a trade paperback. I have most of Frank Miller's run, but some of the key important early issues I do not have. So we great cover here. We got the Kingpin in the background here. Bullseye here. Just great cover here. So we're picking up kind of where we left off. Gang war. And so Daredevil's in the sewer here. I'm tied up. I'm underwater. I can hear the streets. Sounds far above. Sense a long cylindrical tube immediately surrounding me. It's a pipe, a water main. I wake up in the strangest places. So, Frank Miller, story and pencils with Klaus Janson as the inker. Denny O'Neill is the editor, and he will be instrumental in bringing Frank Miller to DC to do Dark Knight Returns and Batman Year One. So, 3 minutes more of this, maybe four, and I'm finished. Have to move swiftly. Can't let the world be deprived of its one and only blind superhero. Of course, if the radiation that robbed my sight hadn't heightened my remaining senses, I'd never find my way out of here. But then I probably wouldn't make a habit of getting myself into situations like this one either. Good thing Turk hasn't gotten any better at tying knots. There they go. That took 1 minute, leaving two. My radar sense is dulled down here, but it can still detect this junction pipe with another pipe. I can feel the current pulling me toward it. This could be the way out. A tight squeeze. If I weren't blind, I might see a light at the end of the tunnel. But I can't, so I just don't know. I'm losing it, blacking out. It's too late. I'll never make it. And suddenly, gasp! I did it. I can breathe. So the water's just rushing into the sewer here. But what's that smell? Oh my gosh, if he's gotten heightened smell. Ah, so putrid here. Money for food, money for food, money for food, say they all. So they're vagabonds living here below the city. Please step away. I can't help you. I'm sorry. So a short time later at Josie's bar here. And here's Turks. I'm sorry, Josie. I'll pay the tab next week. I swear. Just give me another brew. And Josie says, that's what you said last week, Turk, and the week before. This time I mean it, Josie. Honest, I just finished a big job, and as soon as I get paid, I'm going to be rolling in dough. And then he thinks here, yeah, I'd call snuffing Daredevil a big job, all right. And it's going to make me a big man with the King being, yes, sir. After this, nobody's going to mess with me. Nobody who's fond of living anyway. And he's touched, and he's like, sees the red glove. He's like, nah, that ain't, he couldn't. He looks at it again, and it looks up here. And so Turk's going to run away here. And Josie's like, did you have to, Dee Dee? Did you? Oh, geez, he's heading for a window. Dee Dee, please, that's three this week. You know how much some things cost. Don't worry, Josie. Us Daredevils come well-equipped. And so he snags Turk here. And Turk is like, I killed him. I killed him. How'd he get away this time? How? And he says, relax, Turk, I'm not angry, just curious. And he grabs him here and says, well, maybe a little angry. This town's been buzzing with criminal activity lately, and I've been keeping just two steps behind the action. You're going to bring me up to date, aren't you, Turk? And he's like, sure, sure, my pleasure. So Turk is used quite a bit for by Frank Miller. So we're going to get background on the stuff. I have a playlist, so feel free here. Basically, they took his wife, Kingpin's wife, to force him back. And they hired Bullseye to get rid of Daredevil. And they're paying him a crap load. So, and then what happened with Kingpin last issue. And then Vanessa here. So, love this this here, this of Frank Miller is so good. And Klaus Janson just complements them so nicely. So, and then this is all done with color holds here. No ink line here. Love these vertical panels. I always say this, Frank Miller and Todd McFarlane are the best two at doing vertical panels. So the Kingpin has kind of set himself up with a temporary office. He has retired and left the life of crime. He's basically going to turn all his former lieutenants under the bus, and he's going to get a immunity and all sorts of stuff. And now he lives in Japan, and the mob bosses want to kill him. That's basically I summed up why he's here. So, like I said, I have a playlist. So, Kingpin says here, "At the moment, gentlemen, we are safe from attack. Our enemies are unlikely to locate this subterranean stronghold quickly. They are frightened, confused, and capable of swift, decisive action. I know them well. They used to be my lieutenants. I mentioned that we are safe from attack. They, however, are not. But we have insufficient manpower to strike a direct blow at their leaders. Instead, we shall disrupt the machinery of their operations. Machinery I designed and can therefore dismantle. Tonight, immediately, we will dispatch our men to assault the organization's major delivery points, thereby severing the arteries of the East Coast's narcotics traffic." And so here we see it here. "We shall harass their various numbers, runners, making it appear to each that another gang is responsible. By eliminating its key links, we shall shatter their chain information. By tomorrow night, our enemies shall be in terror of displeased out-of-town mobs. I'm sorry. By tomorrow night, our enemies shall be in terror of displeased out-of-town mobs of each other and of me." So here you can definitely see the Kingpin's plans here. Again, love the color holds. This was so beautiful in newsprint. I do use digital, but boy. So this is the building that, and this is all done on color holds. This is the building that the Kingpin is going to take over once he returns as the Kingpin here. So here we have a fly here. And they're like complaining about the fly here. "This building's supposed to be airtight. Doesn't anything work anymore?" And this guy's like, "That's just it, Lou. Nothing's working. A multi-billion-dollar organization is coming apart at the seams. Since last night, nine major narcotic deliveries have vanished. And Detroit's angry, very angry. I don't know how long we can. Seems to me you guys ought to have it figured by now." "I do," says Bullseye. "It's the Kingpin. He's making his move, and he's tearing you to pieces." "Shut up, Bullseye. Just shut up. Talk nice to the assassin, Henry. Right now, he's all you got." And so he's got his paperclip here. "The way I see it, as long as the Kingpin is alive, you wimps are on your way out. I agreed to kill him for 10 million, but to kill him, I gotta find him, and that'll cost you another five." And here he kills the fly and says, "No charge for the fly." And so they agree. And here's Bullseye now, making his way through to find out where the Kingpin is. So, and so this guy finally knows, and he tells them where he is. So, again, another beautiful. So I love these. He's as Frank Miller kind of draws all these panels here, and so Kingpin's kind of dispatching these guys here, getting his work out. And Turk comes in and he goes, "Kingpin, oh, sorry, boss. I didn't mean to interrupt your workout." And he's like, "You didn't. I'm finished. What is it, Turk?" So, it's Daredevil. He's still alive. He's after your files. His timing is unfortunate. Lynch, remove the files to a second vault. I will arrange an ambush at the first. Are you all right, Lynch?" Yeah, sure, boss. No problem." "I still don't like this, Lynch. Only four of us. Suppose DD is onto us," says this henchman. "Shut up, Grotto. If the Kingpin says four men, it's four men. So I worked for the boss for years, lots of them, and he never makes a wrong move." And so the lights go down. He's like, "What happened to the lights?" So here comes Daredevil. Of course, he doesn't need lights. He says, I happen to the lights. So he's got him. He's got the files. Get him. And so he's going up again, using silhouettes, which are Miller's absolute specialty here. So, here's all the bums kind of going through, and here comes Daredevil with it. And so he reports to the Kingpin. He says, by the time we waded through the them beggars, he'd skipped. And Turk says, boss, I thought I'd fooled him. I didn't think he knew. And the Kingpin says, that is because you're very stupid, Turk. Daredevil, on the other hand, has proven himself to be quite canny. However, he should never seek out to outwit the Kingpin. He will learn this very soon. And so he takes this to the police, but it's just newspaper clips. So, it looks like the Kingpin had everybody fooled here. Daredevil thought this was all evidence they could use, but it was nothing. So we go again, love again these things here. And so here comes more of the Kingpin's guys, and then here's oh no, these are, sorry, these are Bullseye's guys here. Love the black and just the white popping out. It looks so cool. He says to them, he's whispering here, that's what these lines mean. Quiet back there. We're right outside the Kingpin's subcellar. Let's not advertise that, okay? Let's see if your boss's battle plan holds any water. So they're gonna open the cover here, and then using either some kind of laser thing or something. Anyway, they break through, and nobody's home. Gotta give Fatso credit. He's sharp as a, and then it falls down. He's like, what the? The ceiling, it's coming down. So, again, another beautiful panel here. Bullseye's like, clowns, that's what you are. Easy, Bullseye, take it easy. Remember which side your bread is buttered on. The Kingpin played you for suckers. He planted the location of his hideout in the head of a very talkative hood, then rigged the joint to collapse on the first person to enter. And me, I was just stupid enough to go along with your saps. He's like, okay, we miscalculated. It happens, but don't worry. As soon as your colleagues arrive, we'll hold an emergency conference and appoint a committee that will. And suddenly, here you see the shadow here, and of course, we see the Kingpin out there. But he says they will not arrive. Each of your colleagues has been approached tonight. Some of them now work for me. The rest are dead. And they're like, the Kingpin is here. Love this. God, Frank Miller and Klaus Jensen, just beautiful work here. Your weakness lies in your numbers. While you formed committees and drafted resolutions, I was free to act with far greater dispatch. The mobs are dissatisfied with your performance, gentlemen. They are ready for my return. Sure, Kingpin, sure. Let's just talk about that. Shall we have a seat? And Bullseye's like, this is way too easy. What's he up to? Weighing out of steam yet, Kingpin. Right. We still got, you still have Bullseye. That's why I'm here. You hired him to kill me, right? Now, he would not find that difficult. However, Bullseye intelligence far outweighs his loyalty. And by now he must realize that your ineptitude shall inevitably destroy you. It is his choice. He can fire a bullet into my brain and consider which of us shall be able to guarantee his future employment at premium rates, of course. Bullseye, please kill him. We'll give you anything, Bullseye, anything at all. And Kingpin says, you have nothing left to offer him. Bullseye, if you please, my cigarette. And he turns it on and says, happy to oblige, boss. You want me to start working right away? I'll give you a group rate for, on the three of them. And he goes, no, this enterprise has resulted in a number of deaths. The authorities shall require scapegoats. Written confessions are being prepared, gentlemen. You shall sign them. And so Bullseye walks him out and says, you heard the man. We had it all. How'd he do it? How? And so Kingpin sits here and he calls for Lynch here. And so, what a knockover, boss. You see the looks on their faces. Boss, he asks, boss, why don't you answer? And he grabs them and just boom. You should never have done it, Lynch. You should never have killed my wife. And he just the tears there of Kingpin showing emotion. He's like, I don't get it, boss. What do you... 4 days ago, I gambled for Vanessa's life. I used a sonic device to disable the crime lords who held her captive. They were helpless. They had nothing to gain by her death. But you wanted me to become the kingpin of crime again. You knew that as long as she was alive, that would not happen. So you killed her. And he's like, no, I stayed in the car. I did. If you had, you would have been unaffected by the sonic device. You would not have suffered the headache you have recently demonstrated. But trust me, Lynch, your torment is just beginning. Stay back, boss. I warned you. But he grabs him by the hand here. Oh, crushes his hand. My life was nothing but the lonely struggle for power. Vanessa warned me, showed me love. You took that away from me. Oh, look at that. One moment of joy. My one brief instant of humanity. He's like, no. And look at this panel here. Just the strong force. And just, you can see it here. And just stuff shattering because he hits him so hard. Oh. And so you can see this patch of blood. He goes, is everything okay in there, boss? Boss? And he's like, there's some garbage in my office. Clean it up. Then get me a doctor. Because he had been shot by Lynch here. And so, again, another panel here. And so we got this streetwalker. She goes, Daredevil, what do you want? Ah, forget it. Come on, Joni. You can talk to me. Uh-huh, hero. You want to talk? You want to know about my boyfriends, and nothing will make me talk about them. Nothing. And so he takes out some money. Not like you to be alone this late at night, Joni. Don't I know it? I got me lots of boyfriends, and they treat me real well, mostly anyway. But tonight, all of a sudden, they all cancel our dates just like that. And when I ask them why, they just tell me to shut up. It's real important, you know. You didn't hear it from me. And so, Daredevil says, Joni's boyfriends include some of the city's biggest gang leaders. There must be a major conference in the works. The kind the Kingpin held the last time he took power. Not a smart place for a superhero to show up. If I had half a brain, I wouldn't. So, again, these... great panel. This thing just kind of ties the whole issue together here. So, okay, we're all here. So what are we waiting for? And so that outburst was ill-advised, Shiv. It's obvious that discipline has slipped since I took my leave of absence. Now listen correctly. I shall restore the organization to its former efficiency, rebuild its decaying machinery. What I require from you is unconditional, unquestioning obedience. We hear you, Kingpin. We hear you. Good, then. We shall. The lights. It's a blackout. Nah, it ain't. Look, the other buildings, they got lights. It's just this one. So, there's just one guy with the nerve to assault this group. One guy. Daredevil. He ain't after you, guys. Any of you. He's after me. We got a big hate going on way back. I want dibs on him, Kingpin. This kill won't cost you a cent. And so Kingpin says, the generator into the basement, Bullseye. You'll find him there. So Bullseye goes down. And somewhere down here, Daredevil, you're waiting for me. You knew I'd come alone, didn't you, you lousy? And so he shoots but ends up killing a rat here. Oh, a cat. So you don't scare me, Devil. You don't. Maybe you can see in the dark. I know you can. But why ain't you attacked me yet? Unless... And so he jumps down. You won't attack me yet. I should have figured. I want you to see, Bullseye. I want you to understand exactly what I'm doing here. I love the screen tones here. It almost looks... And you can see that with the screen tone, there's also another color. So... Do you remember the subway, Bullseye? Do you remember how I stood over you, bleeding, barely conscious? I'd beaten you. You were helpless on the tracks when a train approached. It was going to kill you. I wanted it to. I wanted to hear your bones splinter beneath its wheels. I wanted to hear you scream and die, but I pulled you from the tracks. I saved you your life. Sorry, I saved your life, and you went free, and you killed again. I've been carrying that around me ever since, Bullseye. It hurts. It hurts a lot. Now I'm going to share that with you. You don't scare me anymore, Devil. I'm better than you, and I'll prove it. And he throws his stars here, and Daredevil intercepts them. Your throwing stars won't help you. And he takes out the pistol, and your pistol won't help you, as Daredevil knocks it down with the billy club. We'll settle this here and now, weaponless, man to man. So off they go. Great fight. He sure knows how to, Frank Miller knows how to choreograph a fight. He's dazed, this club, if I can just. And so he hits him in the rib here. No wonder you do so well with this billy club. It's wonderful. The balance is extraordinary. It's a faultless weapon. Only proper that I use it to kill you. And he says, he's got me. One more shot and his gun. And so I said no weapons, Bullseye. And he uses the gun to hit the billy club out. So, and I mean it. And so he punches him. Bullseye deflects it. And here they go. Just wonderful stuff. Oh, Frank Miller had to have a lot of fun drawing these. They think all you think you're better than me. He kicks him in the face. This brick will smash your face. And so Daredevil kind of hits the brick out, crushes it. Doesn't matter. I'm better than you, stronger. And I'll choke the life out of you. Maybe, but I'm taking you with me as they choke each other. And, but Daredevil wins. And suddenly you can see the shadow here getting bigger. And Daredevil looks. Don't twitch a muscle, says this henchman. And so Bullseye is still breathing. You may finish him, says Daredevil. No, I didn't think you would. Daredevil, you have proven yourself an obstacle to me. I would have you shot, but for the fact that I still have you, use for you. These are the files that the state's evidence you have so desperately sought. They are yours to deliver to the district's attorney. Minutes after he receives them, he will issue warrants to arrest the entire echelon of the East Coast. Soon they'll be in prison, and I shall replace them with my men, and you shall eliminate my competition for me. I know what you're thinking, Daredevil. You're planning some desperate feudal attack. You seek to bring me in as well. You're a very passionate man, but it is not your passion that I address. It is your intellect. Consider your position. You have Bullseye. I'll throw him in as a courtesy, and I shall be left with a shattered organization to rebuild for a time. Your side will be that much stronger. Consider the greater good to society, and you shall see that you really have no choice at all. Love the magenta being used here. You win, Kingpin, this time. And Daredevil walks out with Bullseye. And so we get an epilogue here. And Vanessa, this is where the destruction had happened on this little thing. Vanessa, the Kingpin's wife, is alive. And she's hungry. And she's acting like those homeless people in there. So that concludes our issue. And this is on the collected edition that I'm using. And there's this wonderful poster by Miller and Jansen. And you can see here that they used duotones here alongside with the coloring, because this is all done in duotone. Just absolutely brilliant. Daredevil 172 by Frank Miller with Klaus Janson as his accomplice. Beautiful, beautiful work. Like and subscribe, and I do thank you for listening. Goodbye.